All right, today I'm doing a review of SelectTV. This is a new online streaming video service. I picked it up at SelectTV.com for $2.99. Basically, what they're supposed to be is they are an aggregator. They go out and grab all of the TV shows, movies, music, channels from all over the web and bring them into one place for easy access. So say you're looking for an episode of a TV show, they're supposed to tell you where to find it for free, whether it's pay-per-view or part of your subscription. I already did the sign-up process, so we can kind of just jump right into the product here. This is the homepage after signing up. First impressions, I like the interface. It's pretty clean. I like the layout. Looks like they got everything kind of up front here. Some things I noticed that were kind of cool, they have this the filtering over here. So you can kind of choose your different categories over here, or filter by network. So there's a lot of customization. You can filter by genre or your movies. And you can also, kind of a cool feature is you can filter just free stuff or view everything, which is their pay-per-view and subscription stuff. Also another cool thing I noticed was they have personalization. So you can kind of add your own your interest and stuff like that to see, to kind of customize your experience there. So scrolling down, well, up top here, we've got the main slider area, which kind of looks like it's featuring the main content that they're pushing for today. So it's got like kind of a mix of TV shows, movies, and channels and stuff like that. Down here, you got TV networks, shows, movies, and channels. So it looks like the most popular movies and channels and stuff that they have right now, as well as the TV shows up here. So I'm going to start off by picking out a network. Let's just go with CW here. All right, so this is CW. They got a description, some information about the network, and then the shows underneath. I'm going to go ahead and go 14 shows. Go with Arrow. I want to see everything that's available with Arrow, so I'll switch to All here. Alright, so here's the latest free episodes up top here. Looks like I can, yep, I can add some more, view some more free episodes as well. Or down below, I can choose a specific season. So let me just check out season one just for fun. All right, looks like none of these are available for free. I guess it makes sense, they're early on. So let's see where they're available. You got the pilot here. Okay, so if it's not free, they show you where you can buy it or rent it or whatever. It's kind of cool. All right, let's go back to Arrow. So I'm gonna check out one of these free episodes here. Let's check this latest free episode. Okay, so they got a little description of the episode, where it's available for free, and then they also have a subscription. So it looks like it's available with Hulu subscription. I'm just going to check out this buy rent. So yeah, it's the same thing over here. So if there's it's available for rent or buy, they'll let you view that too. Looks like it's also available on other devices. Maybe we'll check that out later. So I'm going to go ahead and choose CW. All right, so it's connecting me to CW. All right. Okay, so this looks like the CW website. Yep. So they're keeping their SelectTV bar up top here, but they're framing in the CW website. So you got an ad playing as usual. I guess they can't really do anything about that. That's from the website. So maybe how long is this thing? Let's see if this is over. Okay, that was pretty short. Alright, so it's actually playing the episode, and I can full screen it. Not bad. And then they got the other episodes down here, of course, because this is the CW website. Alright, so let's jump back to on-demand. Okay, on-demand page. It's a little bit different from the home page. Looks like they got some more TV shows on here and some kids shows and some movies. So I just want to check out one more show here. Match game. All right, similar situation here to Arrow. Pop it up. Okay, this one's available on Hulu. So I'll jump into that one. Connecting to Hulu. Oh. All right, so it looks like this one is embedded versus being an iframe. Let's see if it actually plays the episode. Yep, a Hulu ad, as usual.
Where are you?
Well, the squirrels are back in the attic.
If you're a mom, you call it the worst.
Only 7 seconds, though, so not too bad. Yep, it's the actual show. Alright, so let's go back to On Demand again. I want to check out a movie. Let's go to movies in the sub nav here. Oh, nice. Fear and Loathing. Okay, you got some action movies, horror movies, comedy, sci-fi, drama, classic. Loading some documentaries still. And kids. Looks like a decent selection. Looks like not a lot of the, it's not really new stuff, but still some decent movies. I mean, you got some Sahara over here, Melody Professor. So it looks like mostly stuff from before 2010. Fast Times at Ridgemont High, Joe Dirt. I'm going to check out Austin Powers. Alright, so kind of similar to a movie page. It's got the overview, the cast, genre. Let's check out Watch Now. Okay, so they have a free option, Popcorn Flicks. And then you can buy or rent it on these guys as well. Let me do the free option first, then we can check out what the buying experience is like. Connecting. Okay, so Popcorn Flicks looks like it's similar to what I saw at CW, where it's iframing the content in, and so Popcorn Flicks is the provider. So looks like another ad here, as usual. Again, probably it makes sense that they would have ads because they're not really hosting the content; they're just kind of aggregating it for you. So I'm gonna skip this and go back. I'm gonna assume that works. Let's check out a pay-per-view option. So I'm going to jump out to Amazon. Ooh. Okay, so Amazon is popping me out in a new window here. All right. Yep, so it looks like I can sign in and rent or buy the movie. All right, that's kind of cool. Let's check out a different section. Let's jump to channels, see what we got there. All right. So here we are on channels. So you got kind of a cable grid down below.
Squirrel ain't squirrel world out there.
You've got a channel playing up top. Right now I'm watching Animal Planet live. Doesn't say what's playing, but it looks like it's live. I'm going to check out CBSN, see what's up there. CBS Watch Love News.
There's a line I like, you know, that Dustin says, okay. Six, when she's like talking about
so this looks like it's also live.
I feel that way about Netflix. Netflix is
check out something different.
But that's, I think that's why they're so successful.
Late Night Last Night. Aaron Eckhart on Clint Eastwood.
It would be funny to put that on. I wonder what they'll do.
Okay, so this is like late night shows.
Snakes on a plane.
Alright, so looks like you got live channels and then also this looks like individual videos. You can look ahead and see what's up next.
Kind
of interesting. So over here you got different categories. TV, movies. Let's check out chart toppers. Today's chart toppers.
Come over
Okay.
Save it for another time. Try not to think about you, but it ain't
working. All right, so they got all the different music videos stacked up here. We got 2000 chart toppers, 1990s. Okay, looks like a bunch of options here. So looks like they have they're playing one music video after another on this. So that's kind of their thing here for the music section. I think that's probably enough for channels right now. Seems okay. So I think I was just on music. Yeah, so this is still music. Let's check out radio stations. Okay. So they have a bunch of different genres here. Kind of overwhelming on the genres, but I guess it shows a lot of selection. I'll just stick up top here to, let's go to 70s. Alright. This page can maybe use some remodeling, but I'll see if it works. Pick one. 103.5. Nah. Check out Bay FM. Okay. So it plays the channel. Or plays the radio station for you. I can stop it. Okay. So this radio section's, I feel like it could use a little bit of work. Not quite as good as the TV and channels sections, but I guess it's there. So let's check out events. Alright, this is the events section. So we got Vice President Biden, TMZ Live. Alright, let's check this out down here. You got some live events. Let's check out, let's do cricket live streaming. Ooh. Play suspended. I guess that's not SelectTV's fault, but so they do have the live streams there. So I guess this is for watching stuff that's happening right now versus the channels, which are kind of live scheduled. Let's check out games. Okay, looks like they're just kind of aggregating different games that are available online, similar to TV shows and movies. Alright, one thing I wanted to check out before we finish up was this sidebar here. So let's see, filter down by, let's check out broadcast shows. Okay, so they have these custom pages for each one. You can browse by network, decade, let's check out a decade. Let's go to the 80s. Alright, we're here in the 80s. We've got ALF. It's definitely an 80s show. Alright, 21 Jump Street, Charles in Charge, Cheers, Doogie Howser, Quantum Leap. Definitely 80s shows. So that's kind of cool. You can drill down by the decade and by genre. So overall, the feeling I'm getting from SelectTV is that they go out and aggregate all this content from all over the web. So I guess the value here, oh, that was weird. Value here is just being able to quickly browse and access stuff. They're not quite, it's not like a Netflix where you can just watch anything that they have all in one place. There are some pay-per-view options, but for the most part, there's a lot of free stuff, and it seems like that seems like they have a lot of pretty much every show and movie. It's only $2.99 a month, based on their website and what I'm paying for right here. So for somebody who's looking for kind of a way to easily kind of browse what's available on the web and see what's new and everything, I think it's probably worth that price. If you're already pretty good at finding your way around and figuring out where to watch things and how to find things for free. Maybe not your thing, but overall, I'd say it's pretty good. The channels add kind of a cool aspect to it, too, that's kind of different from the other guys who do the aggregating. So that's my review. Be sure to subscribe and leave comments in the comments section if you have any questions, and I'll try and get back to you. And also let me know if you have any different experience on SelectTV in the comments section. We can kind of discuss. Thanks a lot.